So this week I'm in Chandler, Arizona, ready to help a family who have just brought home a newborn.
Excited.
Hi, we're the Peterfreund Family.
I'm Keith.
And I'm Sonya. We have four boys. Jet's 5 years old, Gage is three, Trey's 2 years old, and baby Myles is a newborn.
You do not get over here. I'm a flight attendant, and so I travel quite a bit.
Bye, boys.
With Keith being gone 4 or 5 days in a row at a time, it is extremely hard on me.
Jet, wait, don't cross.
I'm extremely exhausted at the end of the day. It's really hard for me to take them anywhere by myself.
Hey, put it down.
I don't have enough arms to catch them.
Don't pee on them, I swear to God.
Mom must be exhausted right now, seriously.
Do not go out there, do not.
Jet is our most spoiled. He doesn't listen very well.
What are you doing? Why? Gage is extremely headstrong.
Who's gonna pick up all the crayons off the floor?
I'm here.
No, I'm not.
Yes, sir.
Gage does what Gage wants to do.
When he wants to do it.
At the time he wants to do it. Gage, get over here. Trey is definitely in his terrible twos.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oof. Myles, we're trying to get him to sleep longer at night. Three other boys, they're very high maintenance, so making sure Myles is cared for at the same time is very difficult.
Now.
I mean, these parents are run ragged, aren't they? Look at them.
Trey, don't hit.
Our boys definitely fight a lot. There's days that the fighting can get out of control. We're both really bad at discipline.
Sit down. There's like a threshold where you just give in.
We've tried timeout. I've tried soap in the mouth. We tried hot sauce.
You want me to get the sauce? Let's see how you go faster, go to your room. Put a little bit of dab on his lip. Gage, get down, off the couch, off the couch.
I don't think hot sauce is working here, is it? I mean, let's face it, it's not really teaching the kids much, apart from how to get a burnt mouth.
Do you want sauce or not?
We've tried everything.
What are you doing?
I'm at my wit's end. Stand still. Get off my bed with your get off. We've lost control. Our kids have lost control.
Hey! Supernanny, we're running out of time. We don't know what to do with our kids, and we need your help. Pick it up now, all of it.
Please, come help us.
Okay, Mum and Dad, I know you're running around like headless chickens, but I'll be there very soon and we'll get some perspective on this, okay?
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, nice to meet you.
Thank you, nice to meet you.
I was very excited to meet Jo. I was anxiously awaiting her arrival.
Hi, Gage. How are you? This is Jet. Hi, Jet. How are you?
Hello.
Hello.
This is Trey. Hi, Trey.
Can you say hi?
Hello.
Hello.
This is Myles.
Hiya, little one.
It's really wonderful to help a family with a baby this young. Yeah, it's going to be exciting.
Off the computer.
Dad's a flight attendant, and so he's away most of the time. So I'm quite eager to see how Mum handles the boys when she's on her own.
Excuse me, get down! No, get down!
One of the first things I saw was Gage on top of the playhouse, and Mum was quite hopeless to do anything because she had a baby in her arms.
Get down.
I just feel like I just kind of fly by the seat of my pants. I don't know if it's right or wrong, but it's just what's getting us through the day right now, and it's doesn't always work.
Be careful.
At first, the boys listened to her, but then she went to put the baby down. It was worse because there were two boys on the roof. I also learned that Mum needs eyes at the back of her head. You cannot put a baby down when you've got rambunctious boys running around. My eyes. I was shocked.
Gage, look it. Don't play with baby. He wants to go on his swing and just swing, okay? Okay?
When was he last fed?
He was fed at
11.
Mum's relying on her memory for when her baby's been fed. As part of a baby's growth, it's really important to keep track of their feeding and sleeping intervals. And if there's no written record of that, it becomes extremely difficult to do as a parent.
Would you say that he normally feeds as slow as he's feeding now when he's hungry?
No, normally he's gulping.
Exactly.
So now he's done, because...
Yes, so he hasn't actually finished that, has he?
No, so he probably... He drank two.
If Myles was hungry, he would have finished the bottle. I think mum's overfeeding Myles at the moment. When you overfeed a baby, they can become very uncomfortable and irritable. And then the older boy started acting up again.
I need you to come here for a minute. Give it to me. Oh, put it back in here. Put it.
It's always going to be a dangerous situation when you're trying to discipline and hold a baby at the same time.
No, you're not eating it. Give it. Get it out of your mouth.
I'm trying.
No, you're not trying it. No. No.
Mum got so wrapped up with dealing with the older boys that she didn't see that the baby's head was tilting too far back.
Unbelievable.
No!
Hey, guys! Hey!
You're taking so long.
Okay.
Dad came home and I got a chance to meet him and say hello, but he was swept off pretty quickly into the children's bedrooms because Mum was complaining about all the toys being on the floor.
Let's see what? Did you make this mess? So what do we do when we make a mess?
Yeah,
we clean up. Did you help make a mess?
Yeah.
Yeah, so let's clean it up. Let's clean this up, okay? Where's all this go? Where does all this go? In the chest? What a way to come home. What a way to come home. All right, babe. You want candy? Well, you know what? After dinner, if you clean this up and after dinner, maybe you can have candy. How's that? Deal? Help your brother.
Is this the first time that they're doing it by themselves?
It'll work, but sometimes it takes a lot of threats.
Or bribes.
Bribes, yeah. Unfortunately, sometimes that's what it takes.
We went from, if you pick up your toys, you'll get some candy.
You're tired. Get that.
And then all of a sudden, I saw him picking up the child like a human magnet, where they would then pick up the toy and put it into the toy chest.
Go.
By the end, Dad practically picked up the mess himself. Bit of a cop-out.
This kid doesn't know what he's in for.
What don't you get time to do with the little one that you wish you had time to do? Because just so much.
I feel like he's just left out of my life a little bit.
Give him a bath or anything like that?
Sonya does all that stuff. And when I'm home, somebody's got to keep these three occupied.
Dad gets swamped by the older boys, which means he doesn't get to spend much time with the baby alone, which can be pretty hard on him emotionally. At dinner time, I saw another example of Mum and Dad just not being aware of the needs of baby Myles.
He might be hungry. I'm going to see if he wants some more food.
What's Myles telling you right now?
Well, one of two things. He's either hungry or his diaper's kind of wet. So I was just going to get a bottle ready.
The diaper felt very heavy, but Dad was saying, well, maybe the baby's hungry. And when you've got a newborn, you have to start eliminating what those reasons may be that your child's crying, because your child crying really is your child talking to you.
If you know that he's got a sodden diaper...
Yeah. No, I can feel his diaper is heavy.
Right.
So change the diaper first, and then go and do the bottle.
He's tired. I got him cleaning out your eyes. You know, with him, it's a lot harder for me to figure out what his cry is.
I don't believe you. Instinctively, you knew straight away.
Joan told me to go with my gut. She goes, you knew what you were supposed to do. You didn't have confidence in yourself.
Myles was still crying, so Dad just automatically picked up a bottle without even realising when he'd last been fed.
You okay? Oh, that's not good. Full?
Myles was spitting up halfway throughout his bottle, so they need to be aware of how much he's had.
You got 2 ounces down. I don't think that's that much.
It's taking, like, really weird feeding.
You know, before it was every 3 hours, and now that he's getting older, it's like whenever he cries, it seems.
It'll be really important for both parents to keep a regular feeding schedule for Myles. Spending time here has definitely given me an idea of how chaotic it can be for these parents. For this family, it is about managing younger boys and meeting the needs of a baby. And it's not working right now. That's why I'm here.
I'm going to leave you to all get, hopefully, some good sleep tonight, because I can't wait to come in tomorrow and give you the download on lots of things that we can do here.
We are looking forward to it.
Yeah.
It's been an eventful day, and there's so much that I want to teach them with regards to the newborn. And really, I'm just looking forward to going in tomorrow and having a family meeting and helping them.
So the first thing I want to talk about is discipline.
There is none.
Yeah. Little.
You have threats.
Lots of unanswered threats, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Or bribery for them to do something and behave.
That's true. That's what we feel like. I mean, that's when you tell them something, they don't respect it.
They don't take you seriously because they know that you don't follow through. We tell our children that we don't want them to behave a certain way over and over again, because repetition is how they learn, not hot sauce. You put hot sauce on a child's tongue, it burns their tongue. What's that really teaching?
I don't know if it really taught anything. No. It was just...
Sounds crazy to
no,
me.
No, it's crazy.
It's crazy. I mean... You feel overwhelmed having a five-year-old, two toddlers, a house to run, and then you have a newborn that comes along and it throws a spanner in the works, because you have to learn to adjust and regulate everything again. But however, the needs and the demands of your newborn have to be met. They're a necessity, a necessity. We have only our memory to rely on right now, yeah, on when those last feeds were, how long the baby slept, when the baby fell asleep, and where are we recording it?
We're not.
Nowhere.
We're trying to,
we're trying to record up here.
Yeah,
but of course, sleep deprivation and running around 24, we can't rely on this. You're a flight attendant, so 1 minute you're here and then you're back on the plane again. So, you know, these kids are constantly having this small time with you before you go again.
It's very overwhelming for me to have all four of them, because I'm not here all the time and I don't feel like I have that connection with Myles yet. And with him being fussy the way he is and me not recognizing all that right
and
now,
getting frustrated,
I think that's, it's tough.
What you want for yourself is to feel more...
More confident.
Yeah. Just you looking at your little son yesterday, saying, I'm just not spending enough time with him, and...
Yeah. It's true. It's like... You know, I want to, but I never have a chance because the other kids.
So we need to make that happen.
I'm all in. Let's do that.
Let's get you to a place, both of you, where you feel you can do that. But all the hard work comes now. So we've got enough energy to kick us through this, right?
Yes, we do.
So I look forward to seeing you later.
Okay.
Thank you. My first goal is to address the needs of baby Myles. Mum and Dad spend so much time dealing with their wild older boys that I know it's going to be important for them to record baby Myles' feeding and sleeping intervals. The reason I'm giving you this baby log is because we want to keep track of when Myles is feeding, sleep, and how long for, so that then we can start to form patterns.
Okay.
If we don't have a baby log, then we've got nothing to go by. So the first thing I do know is that you told me that Myles has just had a feed, is that correct?
Just done.
So we can start off by doing that. We can put the time,
yep,
and then the amount,
okay,
that he had.
You can put it down.
A little one?
Sure.
There we go.
I absolutely love the baby log.
Remember, it's not until they're actually having puree foods and milks that you then start to lay down real solid sleeping patterns.
Hopefully these parents can keep up writing in that baby log amongst all of this wild behaviour.
There's your little baby log.
With Dad out of town a lot, it's going to be really important for Mum to be able to manage all of these kids when she's out in public. So I'm going to teach her the roaming technique and how to use her tone of voice.
You're going to explain to them that they're going to the park and we're going to have some fun, but they're to listen to you. Using your tone
is going to be so important, because you're basically commanding them to behave and do as they're told.
She's not really stepping up as an authoritative figure, and her tone would command that, but she doesn't know how to use that yet.
Okay, I want everyone to go to the front door and stop.
And I soon got the chance to teach Mum by example.
Don't open the door. I said...
Right, remember your voice, remember your voice. I want you to keep that door closed. Do you understand me? Keep the door closed.
It's going to be really important that Mum exercises her tone of voice. I believe that when she does, these kids will realise, uh-oh, you know, Mum's being serious. We're going to have to knuckle down here. Baby Myles was sleeping, and because I want to keep him on that schedule, I decided to keep him at home with Dad and put a stuffed animal into the stroller instead. Baby's going in here. In order for Mum to do the roaming technique efficiently, I had her put Gage on one side and Trey on the other.
Jet can be just here.
Okay.
But you never want him running off more than like 7 paces ahead of you.
You're gonna come with me. They're all independent, and as soon as they see the park, they're gone, and I'm thinking, I don't know how this is gonna work. You guys stayed not too far from Mommy.
The fear for any parent when you're out in public with lots of kids is that they may run into the road, and that's why it's gonna be important for Mum to keep things in control.
Hold, Gage.
Stop.
Hold on here.
Stop.
Hold.
All right, Jet's too far.
Jet, you need to stop and wait for me. Okay, no, stop.
Right now, bring him right here. Stop the pram and talk to him.
You need to listen to me. When I say stop, you need to stop right there. There's all these cars parked here. Another car won't see you. Hang on, we make sure there's no cars. Okay.
Mum used her voice very well, and the boys responded. But going to the park gave her a set of new challenges.
Oh, the baby's crying, Mum.
Baby's crying.
Baby's crying hysterically.
Gotta tend to baby. Oh my God, no, you are not. No, you are not. No. Then you do not do it right there. Do you understand me?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
So Mum hasn't done too bad. She's using her voice, actually telling them what to do rather than asking them and staying on top of things.
Okay. Ho, ho.
Jet, I need you to get down. Your brother has to go home.
It's amazing when you just use a different tone of voice that you get different respect.
I do think that Mum did very well today. However, it's going to be a whole different story when she's by herself and she has the real baby in that stroller. We'll see. The next thing on my agenda was to teach these parents proper discipline, because they've been using hot sauce. And quite frankly, I'd like to see that bottle back in the pantry. So I explained to Mum and Dad the process and steps of the timeout.
And when the child gets up from the timeout, take them by the hand and place them back, but without talking to them.
Trey gave Dad the opportunity to use his new learned technique.
Do not hit the computer, okay? We don't hit the computer, no. We do not touch the computer. This is your last warning, then you go to timeout. You understand? He did it again. I put him in timeout for 2 minutes because he's 2 years old. Look in my eyes. When I tell you not to do something, you don't do it. Understand? Thinking this shouldn't be a bad thing. Stay here. Okay, look at me. Now time starts over. Sit. Stay. Stay. That's what you get for being a bad boy.
Don't say nothing. Just take him firmly by the hand, put him back on that bench.
He kept getting up, and I was so frustrated with it. I don't even know how many times I must have sat him down. I wasn't sure if it was going to work.
Do I ever, like, say anything? Like, after a while, just say, listen, you need to sit there for 2 minutes.
No, he knows already by your actions.
Okay.
Your actions speak volumes because it's repetitive. Feel it here, no messing around. Kids can feel that, they know that. And when you're confident and you know, they get it, because they can sense that.
Is there a record for timeouts that you've done?
I want to say 3.5 hours.
So he finally made his 2 minutes, and we finally got done with the marathon. That was something that I thought was never going to end.
Say it like you mean it.
Okay.
He needs to know you're being serious.
Listen, I put you on this timeout because you did not listen to Daddy.
Yeah.
We'll follow through with it. Our kids will know that Mommy and Daddy are boss, and we don't have to give them hot sauce.
Are you sorry?
Sorry.
Okay, then give me a hug and a kiss.
I think that Dad did really good when it comes to disciplining Trey. So I do believe that they can put that hot sauce back in the pantry. But next time, not so much talking. I've done some great work with Mum. I've taught both parents how to do discipline. So now it's time for me to work with Dad. I think it would be a good thing to build Dad's confidence. And that's why I'm going to leave him with all of the kids to juggle.
I'm going to really send you off for a couple of hours so you can go and do whatever you want to do, because I need to get Dad in a place where he's feeling confident with all of the kids.
It caught me off guard because I wasn't at all expecting to be able to just get away for a couple hours, and she wanted me to spring it on Keith. I think I'm going to just go take some time for myself.
That's fine.
For a little while.
That's a good idea.
When Sonya told me, I was a little nervous, but I was worried about, man, if Myles wakes up, if Myles is hungry, and I got the boys over here.
Bye, guys.
Enjoy, yeah.
How am I going to juggle?
Jet, where are you?
This malarkey here going on with Jet is not necessary. He needs to know what you expect from him at that table.
Hey, look at me. Look at me. Right now, I want you to sit at your table. I want you to eat your food. You're not getting down from the table until we're all done. Do you understand?
Jet had been warned, but he still wouldn't cooperate.
Jet, you need to sit in this seat like a big boy. You're 5 years old. Act like it, okay?
Lunch took longer than what it should have, and Dad ran into more trouble when he let the boys out to play.
Trey, get over here now. Now. Trey!
And when it came to Trey's nap, he hit another snag.
Keith.
Yeah?
What are you going to do with your baby?
Personally, I don't think there's a problem with me running inside real quick and keeping him out here, because I feel like the boys, if I tell them not to touch him, hopefully won't.
What are you thinking? Your kids are having trouble listening to you. Right. Stay at the dining table. Take him with you.
Okay.
That way you know that he's inside while you're putting Trey to bed.
Okay.
And he's safe.
Dad eventually did get Trey down for his nap.
Okay, it is now quiet time. If you want to play with those, you can. I know it makes noise, but just play quietly. Quietly. Okay.
Dad did have a successful afternoon managing all of his boys. However, I do know that he needs more time with baby Myles. So with Mum back home to look after the older boys, I knew I could then give Dad that special little cuddle time with baby Myles.
Right, Keith, we're going to do a little bit of parent craft.
Okay.
Myles, bath time.
Oh, sweet. Awesome. When I do get my one-on-one time with Myles, I'm not as comfortable as I thought. I was very comfortable with each of the other kids. And with Myles, I know it's up in the air.
With this, how high should the water be? Because
I don't know. 1.5, 2 inches.
1.5, 2 inches, so my finger.
Keith wants to have that connection with Myles. So even if it's just a 10-minute bath that he gets with him, that's huge.
You're then going to place your index finger and your thumb supporting the neck.
Right.
Since Myles has been born, I haven't even given him a bath. And it's one of my most favorite things to do.
Good job, Myles. Feel good to be clean? Should, I think it's been a little while. All good. You're all good.
After the bath, I wanted to make one more point about applying the baby lotion.
The fact that you can stroke and touch your baby
is
another way of you bonding. And it's just very, very soft. It's your fingertips. Just lovely, firm, round, circular motions or strokes down. It's another way, it's touch.
It's nice. I feel like I'm getting that bond with him. And I feel like he's recognizing me more. I'm finally getting that sense of feeling like we're connecting as son and dad.
After the bath, I thought what I'd do is check that baby log.
He woke up at 4 this morning,
and
he had 4 ounces.
Yeah.
Then he was probably down by like 4:30. Then he slept till 8 this morning.
All right, we need to really put in the details of it, because by the time you get down to like 2 weeks, you're gonna go wake up at 4. When did he go to sleep? So let's have this a bit more thorough.
Okay.
I want you literally
going. You're right, because I won't remember.
There's no way.
Mum and Dad could do with more detail in the baby log, but I mean, they're definitely making progress, and I think it's serving them really well.
Then he slept till 8 a.m.
That's brilliant.
And then he should be down till maybe 4 or 5 in the morning again.
Correct.
Nice. Life is nice.
Joe has helped us to log everything, and it's working very well. Baby's sleeping and eating much better.
When baby's happy, mommy's happy.
Even though Dad travels a lot, I wanted to show him that when he is at home, he could definitely use his imagination to have fun with these boys.
What we have here, Mum and Dad, is a chest
that has lots of accessories inside it. And today what we're gonna do is a big animated story.
Once upon a time, three little boys and their mommies and daddies went on a big, big safari to go look for animals. Maybe some lions,
Ooh,
or
monkeys.
Maybe some elephants.
Creative time with the kids is important. I unfortunately haven't been able to be that creative in a while.
Let's see if there's a cow over here on the safari.
Yes, sir. I'm just so out of
Keith has just done remarkable. He's confident, he enjoys every minute with all of them. So it's so good to see, I love it.
Say hocus pocus and send us home. Say hocus pocus.
I'm ready to name.
Yes, you're ready.
You're ready, go. Hocus pocus, send us home.
Dab us all.
Okay, and then he said, akikukishibaje, and we all went home.
I'm going away for several days. Sonya, what I would love to see is another one of those trips over at the park.
Okay.
But with baby. All right? So.
What I will struggle with most while she's gone is time out. I lose my patience, and now I'm going to get frustrated, and I'm just hoping that we won't need to go there.
We're going to have to remember, there's not octopus here doing 20 things at once, all right? It's recognizing that you do this, and then you can do that afterwards. And
while Joe's gone, the biggest concern for me is the disciplining, trying to get the kids to sit on that naughty chair.
Bye-bye.
It's time for Sonya and I to put everything together that Joe's taught us and make it work.
All right, guys.
Thanks so much, Joe.
I think that these parents have done great. However, it's going to be important to stay on track so that they don't burn themselves out. So they're going to have to be careful. It's been 3 days since I've been gone, which is quite a long time, so I hope they've done well.
Are we ready to watch?
Let's do it.
Yes.
Yes, that was a yes.
Okay, I want to take a look at Dad timeout here.
I don't know how much I'm going to like this one.
Clean up now, Paige. Let's go. No, you just lost it. I asked you and you're not doing it, so let's go to timeout. Well, then you need to start listening. You're the only one in this family that doesn't listen. Sit there. Don't move. When I ask you to clean something up, you will do it. Do you hear me? Look at me. Eyes. Eyes. Don't move. Do not move. Every time you move, the clock starts over. Go see where mommy's at. Look at me. Do you know why you weren't in timeout?
Yeah.
Tell me why.
Because
why? You didn't listen?
I don't know if I like the way I was talking with him, but...
You got to go in with a different attitude. There was this, you stay on the timeout now, because if you don't, then I'm going to move the timer back, and I just want you to know this. What you were really saying was, please stay on this timeout bench. You were begging him to stay there.
Yeah. You so want your child to understand, and you so want him to just get it.
Correct.
And so you're just like, if I can just say it to him, maybe he'll get it.
We expect our young toddlers to get it straight away. But you only remember that through repetition. You're Harold, and you're learning the timeout bench, and we're having to go over it again because the steps are not lodged in there.
Okay.
All right, so Mum outside.
Remember when we walked to the park yesterday?
Uh-huh.
You need to hold on to the stroller. You cannot cross the street by yourself.
Right here.
Get. Stop.
No.
Wait. Anybody coming? No shoes off though, okay? Gage,
we're not dumping sand. Put it back. No.
No, fine, you're not doing it right there. I said not to do it at all. We're going home. I'm not catching you. You're gonna get down here and go get your shoes on now. I'm not playing games. I've warned you.
When I talk to you, you need to listen to me.
Jet, stop. Stop. Stop.
All right, let's break down what happened there. Go in there. Was perfectly fine because you set it up nice and clear. You got them to the park and that was great. But when you started to kick in with a warning, you didn't use the right tone and you didn't use eye contact. You didn't say, down here, right now, otherwise you're going straight into timeout. And that literally would have held it all together.
Yeah.
So as soon as you see that they don't listen the first time, kick in. So let's take a look at your timeout here, Sonya.
Hold on.
You just hit your brother.
Mommy's gonna watch you in timeout.
Sit, please. Can you see the numbers going down? Get up and then you're gonna start again. Sit.
Sit your bottom on the chair. You need to sit here for 3 minutes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Don't get up.
No. All right, it's starting all over again.
No.
Now we gotta start all over again.
I feel tired watching it.
Sit with your bottom on the bench. Sit here on the bench. Sit with your bottom on the chair.
You did it. You do not hit your brothers.
Look at me. Do not tell me that you do not like me. That is very hurtful.
Don't say it.
That was crazy.
Man.
You were chatting to him. It's like you had like you didn't have anything else to do. His leg was cocked up over the seat. He was chilling for his 3 minutes and you were still sitting there saying, right, we've got to stay there, you've got to stay there. I'm like, what part of Gage wasn't actually sitting on that seat at the time? What were you thinking?
So, I don't know.
I tell you what I was thinking. Like a majority of parents, it's really tough for you guys to give discipline.
He actually did as he was told.
He did.
But it was difficult for you to leave him alone.
I don't know why.
Well, you felt like you're a bad parent for doing that. It's part of your parenting. It's your responsibility to raise your children to start becoming more aware of their actions and their behaviour.
So we need to polish up time out.
Definitely. And we're going to work on a few other things as well. So if you guys are ready, we'll continue.
I'm ready.
Let's go.
All right, thank you.
After watching the DVD, I could see that it was important for Mum to still have practice in using her voice to control her kids. So I thought I'd take them to a train museum.
I like trains. Let's start over there.
Part of me was like, oh God. I had it planned in my head how I wanted it to happen and go. Didn't quite go that way.
The boys tested her from the beginning.
Safety, what are we doing? I'm panicking.
Exactly, so deal with it. Okay. Do you think these boys should be allowed up there?
No.
You know, no. This is too high, too big.
No, I think Jet's all right. He climbs slides taller than that. But this little one.
Listen, Mommy doesn't want you to get hurt.
Okay, so Mum, this is where you can turn around and say to him, listen to Mummy and stop climbing up there, otherwise you'll have to hold on to the stroller. Look at his face and deal with his behaviour.
We cannot go on that train.
The stroller, Mum, the stroller. Stop that behaviour right now. If you misbehave like this anymore, you're going to be holding on to the stroller. Do you understand me? Look at me. Do you understand me? Then behave yourself. Otherwise, you'll hold on to the stroller.
Mum, you see the little one like that, straight away, just say to him, this behaviour and you're holding on. Once you address it, you saw he went completely quiet.
Right.
Whilst exploring the trains, the boys gave Mum a good chance to practice.
Trey, I need you to come to Mommy. Trey, you need to come over here to Mommy right now. Trey, you need to come over here to Mommy right now. If you don't come over to Mommy, you're gonna hold on to the stroller. Thank you.
Right, so you told him 3 times before you said the stroller. Next time,
stroller.
Tell him once, stroller.
Got it.
Mum has certainly come a long way in feeling more confident using her voice, but I want to clarify what she's learnt today.
After your first conversational tone, nip in with the lower tone, that basically is telling them that they need to listen and respond straight away, and when you're feeling panicked, have them hold on to that stroller.
Mm-hmm. In the past, when we were out in public, we didn't really have a plan in place, so this gives me a sense of ease. I know that they're listening, so I feel better.
Both parents have got discipline underneath their belt. However, they do like to talk a lot, so I'm going to give them a written reminder.
It's just something very simple for you so that when you are doing the timeouts, it can just jog your memory, okay?
I love that Joe gave us a plaque because when you do get caught up and you're getting frustrated, just to look up and be like, oh, okay, keep me on track.
And that's going to stay up there for a long time.
I'll work on two, you work on four.
Yes.
And then later on, Mum had a chance to go through all the steps when Gage had a bathroom mishap.
You peed in here?
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
But I peed in here.
You peed in here?
Yes.
Come here. What you just did was very wrong. You know that you do not go pee-pee in the wastebasket. Where do you go potty?
In a toilet.
Okay, so, 3 minutes.
No!
Yes.
No.
We need to reset the timer.
Sit your bottom on the chair.
It's hard to just not want to say anything.
Mom, look at the timeout reminder.
Walking away.
I'm constantly wanting to be like, just sit and it will be done.
Mom didn't say a word and Gage stayed put for 3 minutes.
Minutes are up, you go over and tell him firmly. You don't have to be angry, you just have to be assertive.
Do you know why you sat in timeout? Why?
When Gage completed his timeout, I was very pleased that we both did it. So it was good.
Number four is to explain.
With solid practice of getting this discipline down and a written reminder, there's no way really these parents can fail.
Okay. Hey, Myles.
What's up, baby? You know, I tell everybody who's going to be a dad, it's just the best experience you'll ever have in your life.
As a flight attendant, Keith is often away from his family and sometimes days at a time.
I've missed a ton of my kids' life. It's a job and I have to do it. It's heart-wrenching, you know, when I'm not here.
I want to give you something that I think will be really fun for you. As you can see, we have Mummy and your boys.
That is awesome.
And if you open up each little window and pull out the paper, you'll see that there is a nice little opportunity to leave each one a little message. And when you do leave, Mummy will be able to read that out to boys, you know?
This is great. Since I'm leaving tomorrow, Joe thought it'd be a good idea if I go ahead and write the notes out right away. It's just a way for the kids to know I'm thinking about them. That was one of the best things I've gotten.
I think that the notes definitely are gonna make it a little bit easier.
I left you a note. And Mommy can read you a note.
I could give it to them and they can kind of hold on to it and just kind of have a little piece of Daddy when he's not there, knowing that he wrote those specifically for each of us.
Look at, even Myles is up in the front.
Well, hey, continue on your journey and keep in touch.
You will.
Keep in touch.
I just want to thank JoJo from the bottom of my heart for a wonderful, wonderful experience.
Thank you.
Thank you for everything.
You're more than welcome.
You're gonna be missed.
Okay.
I mean, all of us, Gage, Trey, Keith, myself, we've all taken away so many wonderful things.
Bye-bye, JoJo. On the
couch. I love JoJo.
Bye-bye.
I think we have the proper tools in place to accomplish anything we want to accomplish now. But the learning still has to go on. Just like life is gonna continue. Our kids are gonna grow.